Why don't you do your famous note trick?
You want to see Reg's famous note trick, do you? Yeah. Right, well, yeah, let's have some that. Let's be seeing who we got in today. Right, I'm going to need to borrow some money from someone. Literally some holding and folding, proper cash. Or this show goes no further. I've got an hour, so who's getting in their pockets? Come on. You look like you've got a bob or two. Get it out. And this guy here, who actually doesn't look like he got a bob or two. I'll talk. There we go, look. What was your name, eh?
Sam.
Sam! Thank you very much for the donation there, Sam. Sam, this is your 20p note. Archie, play the track, if you would. Not the bloody track, is it, Archie?
Play the proper one. I mean, his mother says he's mine, but, you know.
Right, here we go. This is Reg's famous 20p note trick. Based on the ancient art of Oregon. We call this just so. It just starts to look a little bit more like 100 notes.
Thank you very much, mate, for the donation.
Sadly, sort of looks like Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, but actually, he's beating me right now. All right, fair enough. Just for you, mate, we'll bring it back. I would have given that money to charity, incidentally. She works by the dog and trumpets, you know. Right? All right, here we go. Just for you, mate, back to your 20p note. Just like... some volunteers to come up at certain points during the show. Now, I'm just going to let you know that nobody's going to get, like, slandered or robbed or lied to or made to look foolish for helping out. In fact, by helping out, you're going to have the best possible time. Deep down, I just want you to have a lovely time, see some great magic tricks, and have a bit of a giggle. So, we got ourselves a deal? Yeah. Sounds proper lovely!
Right, I'll teach you my catchphrase. Catchphrase does lose a degree of potency if I'm going to teach it to you, but it goes like this. I say,
sounds proper lovely, and you all shout, yes, yes it does, Reg. You got that? Right, have a little practice. Sounds proper lovely.
Yes, yes it does, Reg.
Oh, you daft buggers, I like you, not. Right, and also just a general reminder, of course, Reg Kettle is eligible to win the competition as well.
In fact, I have won this 9 times, it's fair to say. Got a couple of twigs up my sleeve. There you go, mate. You can eat that.
No.
I wouldn't, yeah. Had that a while. I bought that in a multi-pack with a marathon bar. It's been there sometime. If I give it back, I'm not.
We'll save that for tomorrow, won't we? There you go. Perfect. Right, so
other things, you know, you can book Reg Kettle. He's always available if you wanted to book me for, you know, TV shows and weddings and wakes and like bar mitzvahs, birthday parties, bit bar work, bit beer lifting, you know. It's been a quiet time, so I am in the phone book, call the landline before I have my tea. Yeah. Very quiet.
Right, before we kick things off proper, I just want to do one proper grown-up magic trick. This is, I don't get to do this at kids' parties in Barnsley. They are fucking feral, I can tell you that now. The kids are pissed before you even get there these days. So my trick is this. On this board here, I've written down some numbers. These are the numbers that mean something to me. And in a moment, I need you lot to think of numbers that mean something to you. Could be anything, but it must mean something to you. So, for instance, it could be age you had your first shagging, 13. Age you had your first pint, 14. Age you had your first pasta with a carbonara sauce, 41. Just whatever you like, just got to mean something to you. I'm going to get 5 volunteers. You don't need to come up, but just stand up where you are. Gentleman with the glasses on his head, up you get, mate. You stand there, you're number one. Lady on the second row, try not to look at me. You are number two, get up. Shaggy from Scooby-Doo, you're up, number three. This gentleman here, lovely. the Twix man there. And finally, let's go for the bald-headed gentleman, sort of about 5 rows back, who is quite tall and is now
is now looking like Quasimodo, sort of hunched over in the corner.
Right, so I'm going to get you lot all to think of numbers. Hopefully they'll match up with the ones that I've already thought about. Keep them under 50, we'll be here all bloody day. And maybe for my OCD sake, maybe you do like 1 to 10, 10 to 20, 30, you get the idea, right? Perfect. Make you are up first, what's your name?
Matthew.
Matthew, right, fair enough. What number have you gone for, Matthew?
Seven.
Just number seven, what does number seven mean to you?
Well, I thought the number bigger than 50 instead of 11.
Fascinating, sit down. Right, who's on that club? Yeah, you. What number do you go for?
18.
Number 18, that's number 1 and 8, yes? 18?
Yep.
Any interesting stories to share with the class?
No.
Right, there we go. I'm going to have to work for it today, aren't I? Well, what have you gone for?
21.
He's gone for 21, lovely. Oh, nice accent. Where's that from?
Germany.
Well, good stuff, good stuff. I think we have a German competition entrant later, which you may or may not find offensive. Who have we got next?
24.
We've gone for number 24, lovely. That's 2-4, not... Yeah, 24. Perfect, lovely. Sit down, mate. Quasimodo.
47.
Number 47, right up there, lovely. There. Number 47 at the top. Now, in front of every great magician is a great magician's assistant, but Amadri's hips are playing up, not what they once were. So, I have the numbers written down here, and I'm going to get somebody up from the audience to be the assistant. Let's have a look. Yes, yeah, the lovely lady here. There you go, lovely. Lovely. Nope. The lovely lady over here. Give her a round of applause. Your name was?
Jess.
Jess, good to see you, Jess. Do you know your lines?
No.
Fucking hell, right. Jess, basically what's going to happen in a second is you're going to turn around that board there. It's going to match the numbers that we have predicted, 7, 18, 21, 24, 47, and you're going to take the applause. You ready?
Okay.
Gorgeous! I think what's happened here is Jess has screwed me over. I've just realised I was actually supposed to be making you all think of words, not numbers. So, was anyone thinking of a house? Put it down, Jess. Right, okay, Jess, go back to your seat. Actually, no way, Jess. Jess, no, no, no. Don't humour her, she's done nothing. Come here. Jess, come here. I'm gonna try and pass off a coincidence as a magic trick. Because I've just remembered that I do play the lottery every week. And chance would have it. I keep my lottery ticket inside my wallet, zipped up, inside a little zipper, inside an envelope, sealed up so that my missus can't find it. Because frankly, she does not appreciate me wasting the money. And if I did win, I'd be off down the Costa del Sun before you could spell D-E-V-E-R-O-S. She's not in, is she? Oh, right, Jesse, you're going to be the audience's eyes for this bit. Here we go. Inside my wallet, here we have, hopefully, a zipper. Jesse, would you like to undo my zipper? Go for it. Hold that one, yeah. Right, check this out, Jess. Fingers crossed, inside here, we should have ourselves a... Have you got any special music for this? Look at all our cheese. Crazy game. Right, here we go. Can you see inside here? We have something very special. There, actually, open. Inside, we have a lottery ticket. Now, I tell you this. If this matches the numbers you've chosen, that'd be pretty bloody good, wouldn't it? Right. And we'd go mad for our first act to welcome him out with some love, yeah? Read them out nice and loud into the microphone. We have numbers.
7, 18,
yeah.
21,
yeah.
24,
yeah.
And 47.
Ladies and gentlemen, shall we get our first act of the evening out?